Welcome to a new semester and a new class. The course number is a little crazy. It's INST 735, CMSC 723, and Ling 723. In other words, it's split between computer science, information science, and language science. And that's what makes the course fun. So first, why is it a computer science course? We'll be talking about some really amazing algorithms for understanding the structure of language, how to turn a sentence into a structured object computers can understand. You'll be able to show off your ability to create dynamic programming algorithms, see how the Chomsky hierarchy applies to natural languages, and write some Python programs that do some really cool stuff. And we'll use some of the cutting-edge transformer algorithms that you might have heard about and that have been taking over the rest of artificial intelligence. You'll see why they were developed and how they work. And of course, the connections to the University of Maryland. So why is this a linguistics course? Because the inputs to these algorithms are natural language. That's why the course is called Natural Language Processing. So we'll talk about syntax, pragmatics, and semantics. Sometimes it will be figuring out the structure of a sentence. You can interpret a sentence like, "I saw the dog with a telescope," in two different ways, at least. Either looking at the dog with a telescope, or a dog that happens to have a telescope. And we'll use probabilistic notions of syntax to figure out the most probable answer. Other times you'll have to figure out what a word means, and that means representing the word either with a graph from WordNet or a vector representation from something like Word2Vec. One of the most exciting things about working with language is that it reflects the culture and society that created it. For example, how trade and immigration brought cochiap, or preserved fish sauce, from southern China to Portugal to Heinz ketchup. This story and many others are told in Dan Jurafsky's book, The Language of Food. And then there's the social implications of using the kind of technology that's squarely a part of information science. How do you ethically deploy applications of artificial intelligence and natural language processing, and how can you detect things like bias in these applications? And from a technological perspective, there are things that are just natural language processing. How do you translate "my hovercraft is full of eels" into Hungarian? How do you get a computer to answer a question? And how do you turn the phrase "1930s bear market" into an image?
My hovercraft is full of eels.
Because this is a multidisciplinary class, lots of people come to this class with different backgrounds. So what kind of preparation do you need to do well in this class? From the math side, you'll need to know how to solve an equation, take a derivative, and you'll need to do that for expressions that contain functions like the exponential function, logarithms, sometimes, occasionally, trigonometric functions. And those sometimes are parameterized by the outputs of linear algebra expressions. So you'll need to know what it means to multiply matrices, both normal products and Hadamard products, and transpose matrices or take a dot product. To be clear, most of the time these will be executed by a computer. So you won't have to do it by hand. I'm not going to ask you to invert a 5x5 matrix in your head. But you might need to multiply a 2x2 matrix by 2x1 vector on an exam. Nothing too crazy. On the computer side, you'll need to be able to code in Python. For homeworks, you won't be coding from scratch. Instead, I'll give you a template that you need to fill in. I use classes, unit tests, and modules for my Python programs. If you don't know what those are or how to use them, you should probably get up to speed quickly. You won't need to make them yourself, but you'll need to know how to use them. And you'll need to be able to read and write from files, upload them to the submit server for your homeworks, and later you might need to, say, compose a Docker file for your project. Because I teach other classes that cover the basics, I have a bunch of optional videos that you can look at this week. But there's lots of great references available online for you to choose from. Now, there's also an undergraduate natural language processing class at the University of Maryland. I sometimes teach that class. So how is this class different? Well, we're going to do more, go faster, and thus cover more stuff. But even so, if you took my undergrad class here at Maryland, you're going to see a lot of overlap. But But while the undergrad course was fairly focused on question answering, the grad course is a little more open-ended. But because I'm me, you're still going to see a lot of question answering in this class as well. And because the work of NLP research is never over, a bigger difference is that this course will try to lay the foundation for you to be part of the research community. We're going to talk about how to contribute to the community as a researcher. This is just one video from a course that I'm teaching. If you want to get the whole context, check out the course webpage linked below. There you can find all of the videos in the right order. YouTube likes to show you older videos out of order, homeworks, exercises, and recommended readings. And if you want to help other people find videos like this, please be sure to like and subscribe to provide a big gradient to the algorithm.